The finish line is near for aspiring politicians like Filipino-American Ysabel Jurado as Super Tuesday draws closer. Jurado is running to be the first Filipino to be elected to the Los Angeles City Council. And after months of campaigning, the tenant rights attorney will know on the March 5th primary if she will continue her campaign into the November election.
I'm so surprised and delighted with the outcome of our campaign. We're building so much momentum. There are more signs and mostly people saying they support us. And we started from nothing. And now I feel very confident that we're going to make it into the runoff in November. It's about folks getting to know me and uplifting the work that our community is already doing. And it's really about grassroots organizing. That's the root of this campaign. And it's really been more positive and connecting with folks, and that's really why people are invested and committed and supporting us.
Born and raised in Los Angeles, Jurado, who served many vulnerable low-income and immigrant families, says the campaign has given her a chance to know the community on a more personal level.
I've learned so much on the campaign trail, talking to so many different people, and you know, finding out the parts of this district that have absolutely like been neglected. You know, people who pay taxes and also just their curbs aren't getting repaired or their trees not getting trimmed, but also, you know, so much apathy and people being so disappointed in politics and government. And me talking to them and being the first person that has ever knocked on their door or candidate running for city council. And when I speak with them and I can give them a little bit of faith in me or hope in our process that we can change it, that has been one of the greatest gifts, knocking door to door and meeting folks.
This past weekend, Filipino elected officials and leaders came out in support of Jurado at one of her final Get Out the Vote events.
Panays are electable in every district.
Yes! Woo!
There is no better leader, no stronger leader than a Tita fighting for her own people and her own community that she loves. No better.
History-making City Controller Kenneth Mejia says having council members like Jurado would help the community when it comes to taking on the research data and budgets that his office oversees.
It's a legislator who could take what we put out and push the recommendations, act on the data that we do bring about to actually make it happen for systemic change. And that's why we need Ysabel in office here, because we need members who actually will take that work and change people's lives.
Eight candidates are vying for LA's 14th district, which stretches from Eagle Rock to downtown Los Angeles. The ballot includes incumbent councilmember Kevin De Leon and a pair of state assembly members in Wendy Carrillo and Miguel Santiago. Unless one candidate receives more than 50% of the votes, the top two vote-getters from Tuesday's primary will face off on the November ballot. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Eagle Rock, California.